dahil sa testimonya nila at ng mga lulutang pang testigo, maaring ikaw ay masampahan din ng qualified human trafficking, walang piyensa, capital offense. Nakahanda ka ba dito, Ms. Ong?
I move that Ms. Cassandra Ong will be detained in the Women's Correctional Center. So move, Mr. Chairman.
There is a motion to detain Cassandra Ong at the Women's Correctional Center. Any objections? Hearing none, the motion is approved.
Mr. Chair, during the time that we have conducted that committee hearing, that joint committee hearing, Cassandra, in the spirit of transparency, you know, Cassandra, no, I will tell the body, you know, that you texted me and you called me para at least malaman nila kung saan tayo magsisimula. But the reason why you called me is to ask for help kung ano yung dapat mong gawin. Am I right? You can answer.
Yes po.
Yes, and during our conversation, sinabi mo kung ano yung dapat mong gawin. Is this correct, Cassandra?
Yes po.
All right. And sa text mo sa akin, no? And I know that this came from your heart, no? Sinabi mo dito sa text mo na, "Hi Kong, thank you for the time to pick up the call. Sana matapos na po, puro na lang allegation. Pag-pray ko din po, maging fair enough din po. I'm not involved in politics and will not po. Ayaw ko din pong madamay sa away po ng malalaking tao. Mabuhay po ang Pilipinas, mabuhay si PBBM." So you texted this, di ba? You remember? And you were saying na ayaw mo ring may madamay na sa away ng malalaking tao. Are you referring to sinong personality are you trying to imply on your text?
I invoke my right to remain silent po.
I invoke my right.
Yes po.
To your right. Mga politician ba ang sinasabi mong ayaw mo ma-involve sa away ng malalaking tao?
Opo.
At saan ka madadamay ng mga away na sinasabi mo sa text mo sa akin? I never replied, di ba? Hindi ako nag-reply sa'yo eh. Because I really don't want you to answer back on my cell phone. What I wanted is for you to appear on the committee and to answer to all of us. So, sino?
Mr. Chair, I invoke my right po to remain silent po.
Congressman Akop?
I would just like to remind Madam Cassandra Ong and her lawyer that what we are conducting here is not a custodial investigation where you can invoke your right to remain silent. There have been Supreme Court decisions on this. So I think the witness has to answer. Otherwise, we will move to citer in contempt for refusal to answer.
Mr. Chair, the reason why I started our hearing with the parameters on the use of right to self-incrimination is to guide our resource speaker as to when they can be availed of and when they cannot. And as far as this representation is concerned, Mr. Chair, we have two elements before they can avail of the right against self-incrimination. One, there must be identifiable crime. And two, there is the probability that the resource speaker may be convicted of the crime. Now at this point, Mr. Chair, may we ask Ms. Cassandra Ong, nung tinanong ka ba ni Honorable Dan Fernandez, kaninong away ang iniiwasan mo? Ano bang krimen ang iniisip mo na baka ikaw ay madamay?
I refuse to answer po para sa own reason ko po.
If I may, Congresswoman Luistro, I'm sure it is upon the advice of your counsel, Attorney Topacio, kaya mo sinasabi that you refuse to testify or the right against self-incrimination, etc., etc. Pero maliwanag po na marami pong sinight na mga jurisprudence tungkol dito. Because as it is, she is already detained in the house, and once the committee rules on citing her in contempt again, she probably would stay in this detention facility much longer. Kaya please, advise your client to cooperate. As long as her rights are not violated, we will continue to ask her questions.
Mr. Chair, pwede po ako mag-excuse sa sarili ko ng like 10 minutes lang po.
Excused for 10 minutes?
To consult po.
To consult with your lawyer?
Kung yan ang problema. Kasi if we give you 10 minutes, alam mo, kanina pang umaga, itong ating mga resource persons naghihintay.
Yeah. And Mr. Chairman, I think the resource person must consider na, well, she's not special. Hindi po kayo lamang ang resource person that we are investigating. All of these resource persons have been here since morning. Lucky you are in your own room, di ba? Meron kang aircon, meron kang sariling kwarto. But all of these people who are working tirelessly to spread the truth has been here for so long. We hope you understand, and you're asking for 10 minutes for us to wait another 10 minutes. I think, Mr. Chair, that is unacceptable. And Cassandra, what is the reason for a 5-minute suspension that for you to talk to your lawyer? Are you asking for a 10-minute...
Yes, po. Yes, po.
And what's the reason behind?
Mr. Chair.
Okay, sige. We will allow you for a 5-minute conference with your lawyer, provided that pagbalik mo, you will tell the truth. Is that clear?
Mr. Chairman, I object. Because we've been waiting here for so long. Let's start with this now.
Please proceed, Congressman Dano.
Okay, I hope, Cassie, you know, you'll be answering all the query of all these members who are here. Precisely because you are a Pilipina. These are all the torture victims na nakuha sa cellphone doon sa Porac at sa Banban. Ito naman yung mga namatay. They are 66 foreigners. Hindi makilala kung bakit sila namatay. Lahat sila, almost all Chinese. Natagpuan sila, almost everybody sa Region 3. So, nakita mo na ba sila? Hindi pa. Hindi pa rin.
Hindi po.
Okay. The reason why I showed you all these pictures is for you to realize the gravity of what you are into right now. Are you a incorporator of Lucky South 99?
Hindi po.
Cassandra, are you an incorporator of Lucky South 1999 since 2019 to the present?
I think assistant lang po, pero hindi siya incorporator.
You are an executive assistant?
Tawag po dito, otori.
Correct?
Yes po.
19 years old. Paano ka nakapagtrabaho sa Lucky South 99?
Mr. Chair, I refuse po to answer.
Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Chair, point of order.
Point of order.
It seems that it's Attorney Topacio answering. So I think we should... No, I've been watching you and you've been whispering. So can we please give the resource person the opportunity to answer truthfully?
Attorney Topacio, may we ask you to refrain from answering in behalf of your client? As we clearly stated earlier, the role of the counsel is only limited to advising your client of his or her constitutional right.
I refuse to testify po. Sorry, Mr. Chair.
Tinatanong ko lang kung ano yun ang unang mong trabaho. Pwede mo naman sabihin iba ang trabaho mo, di ba? You study in the Philippines?
I refuse po to testify po.
Attorney Topacio, let this be a warning to you to please allow your client to respond to the question. Bakit refuse to answer? Patipilitan kami i-contempt ka.
Mr. Chairman, parang yes, yung sa paper ni Cassandra, meron na kagad sagot na pinuturo ni Attorney Topacio eh. Di ba? So I will give you another chance, Attorney Topacio. Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Chair.
Please proceed.
I move to cite Cassandra in contempt.
Second.
There is a motion to cite Cassandra Ong in contempt.
In the spirit of due process, may we ask that the witness explain why she should not be cited in contempt?
Kasi there's a contempt order now for Miss Cassandra Ong, in which her violation is refusal to be present in the previous hearing until he was cited in contempt, Mr. Chairman. But this is the first time in the history, in my 11 years in Congress, for those cited in contempt, two contempt orders.
And in the spirit of fairness, we would like to give her the opportunity to answer.
Regarding the invocation of the right to remain silent or right against self-incrimination is not absolute. Now, Ms. Ong, through the chair, most respectfully, kindly justify your refusal to answer that question.
Again po, Mr. Chair, I refuse to answer or to testify po.
So you refuse to testify. In other words, hindi ka na sasagot?
Opo.
Now, Ms. Ong, ang sinasabi lang po ni Congressman Rodge, bibigyan ka ng pagkakataon, explain sa amin kung bakit mo nire-refuse yung mga simpleng tanong. So bakit ho ganun yung inyong asta ngayon?
Marami pong reason. Una, under oath po ako dito. And possible po siya magamit against me in the future po.
Naintindihan mo ang sinasabi namin, Cassandra? In fact, binigyan ka ng pagkakataon na ni Congressman Roger Gutierrez na sagutin yung mga tanong na hindi naman incriminating. Gaya ng binanggit namin kanina na mga jurisprudence, ay hindi ka pwedeng magtago diyan sa right, yung right against self-incrimination mo sa pagdinig na ito, dahil pinapayagan ng desisyon ng Korte Suprema na ikaw ay i-compel na sumagot sa mga tanong.
May I request, with all due respect to Attorney Topacio, to please sit behind Ms. Cassandra Ong.
It seems to be he is supplying already the answer to the resource speaker. A situation which we do not allow.
Is there any motion?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. For the second motion, Mr. Chairman, I move that Ms. Cassandra Ong will be detained in the duration in which until the committee report will be adopted in the plenary, Mr. Chairman. And it follows that the investigation will be terminated.
So until we terminate, hanggang matapos itong committee hearing na to, you are cited in contempt and you will be detained.
This second contempt will mean detention where?
Wala pa.
And it does not necessarily mean that it will be here. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
I move that Ms. Cassandra Ong will be detained in the Women's Correctional Center. So move, Mr. Chairman.
There is a motion to detain Cassandra Ong at the Women's Correctional Center located at?
Mandaluyong.
Mandaluyong. It's a detention facility, Women's Correctional. Duly seconded. Any objections? Hearing none, the motion is approved.
It is apparent to me that Ms. Cassandra Ong is turning emotional upon hearing the detention in the Women's Correctional in Mandaluyong. And you should really worry about that. because the facility is entirely different from the detention that you are experiencing here in Congress. I wish to ask, Mr. Chair, if Ms. Cassandra Ong is willing to avail of the executive session to give us the chance to reconsider the earlier contempt order, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Thank you, Congresswoman Luistro. Gusto mo ba mag-avail ng executive session na kung saan ay ikaw ay magko-cooperate sa aming committee sa investigation na ito?
Kasi baka you want to say something sa executive session, ibig sabihin kami-kami lang. So if you wanted to avail on that privilege, you can do so para hindi na didinig ng buong bayan. Kasi I have to remind you as well that this involves human trafficking, no bail yan. It's about, ano kasi, ganito ka simple, kasi, listen, please, stop whispering to her, stop. Pabayaan natin siya mag-isip ng sarili niya. Malaki na si Cassie, she knows what to answer. And we will be helping you. Remember, when I told you, over the phone, we will help you. Just cooperate, be truthful, be honest. You are a Filipina, di ba? Maaring hindi ikaw ang may kasalanan. Katulad ng tinext mo sa akin, ayaw mong maipit sa mga nag-uumpuga ang malalaking batong yan. You tell us. Samahan mo kami. Tandaan mo lahat ng mga tao na kapaligid sa'yo.
Pwede pong pag-isipan.
Sige. But again, we will be warning you. Ha? The Filipino people are watching right now.
Cassandra, pwede bang makinig ka lamang, no? I am willing to withdraw my motion or I will tell us the chair to withdraw this ruling kung willing ka na. Pag makinig ka kay Congressman Dan Fernandez, ginagawa mo ito hindi para sa amin kundi para sa mamayang Pilipino. Please.
Bigyan po natin ng pagkakataon yung sinabi niya na she wanted to think about it herself. Okay? Attorney Harry Roque was telling us that he is your lawyer. Who is your lawyer? Si Topacio ba or si Harry Roque?
Sa Whirlwind lang po.
Sa Whirlwind lang siya lawyer. Dito sa pagdating mo sa Congress, ang lawyer mo na ay si ano?
Attorney Topacio.
Okay, that's good. Will you confirm that you were with Al Tenco during that time with Attorney Harry Roque and you paid those amount that he mentioned?
Yes po.
Yun. Thank you so much. And those two cash deposit slip, November and September 15, 2023, in the amount of $100,000 and $200,000, you also transmitted this amount.
Yes po.
Ayan. Thank you. You are also the beneficial owner of the Whirlwind Corporation. Am I right?
Whirlwind lang po.
Merong malalaking tao na nakapaligid sa... You want to have an executive session with that? Para at
I'm
least...
still thinking pa po.
Ha?
I'm still thinking pa po.
You're still thinking?
Yes po.
Yung tatlo bang yon na kilala mo? Yung tatlong incorporators na yan?
Naka-video call ko yata.
Naka-video call mo sila? Okay.
I think one time through Dan.
16.7 million.
Your Honor, I will check the transaction.
This is 16.7 million. Ang laki nito para makalimutan mo. Meron ba?
Ang natatanda ko po 16 million.
Sa iyong asawa, kay Rachel Ann Linsangan. Yes or no?
Your Honor, ang natatanda ko po sa transaction na yan, meron pong nabentang property.
Okay, sino ang katransaction mo sa 16.7 million? Anong lupa? Saan?
Yun po sa...
Saan?
Yung sa binanggit niyo pong lugar, Your Honor, Puting Kahoy.
Saan lugar? Puting Kahoy. Gano'ng kalaki? Ilan square meter?
2,500 square meter,
Your Honor. 2,500 square meter? 16 points. How much per square meter?
Meron, Your Honor. Representative lang po ako, Your Honor.
Representative ka lang? Paano ka nag-transfer ng 16.7 million? No, Your Honor. Sa Y2.
Hindi po.
Yes, to health.
Hindi po transfer, Your Honor.
Manager's check.
Kilala mo si Cassandra Leong.
Yes po, Madam Chair.
Bakit mo siya kilala?
Parang siya po yung boss ko po, Mr. Chair.
Siya ang boss mo?
Yes po, Madam
Chair. And as your boss, anong mga orders ang ibinigay niya sa'yo at sinunod mo?
Aside from signing documents po, Madam Chair. Documents po, tsaka po sa check po.
Documents and checks. Na kaninong pangalan yung mga check
Meron po akong nakapangalan sa akin. Minsan po nag-uutos po siya, halimbawa mag-issue ka ng halimbawa po 10 pieces worth of like 15,000, ganun po. Tapos sinusulat ko po.
In other words, Ms. Baterna, ikaw ay taga-issue at taga-perma lamang. Tama ba?
Tama po, Madam Chair.
Pagkaka-issue at pagkaka-perma mo, ibinibigay mo na kay Cassandra Ong, at si Cassandra Ong na ang bahala kung anong gagamitin niya sa cheque. Tama ba?
Yes po, Madam Chair.
Ms. Mascareñas, do you know Cassandra Lee Ong?
Yes po.
Why do you know her?
Kasama ko po siya sa office. Pero most definitely nauna po ako sa kanya. Tapos, ang alam ko, parang personal translator siya ni Mr. Wu. Tapos lagi siyang kasama sa mga meetings. Tapos, until such time na siya na rin po yung nagipag-deal sa lahat ng mga kung sinong dapat kausapin. And yung mga papers, kinuha na rin po niya before ako tanggalin nung December.
Second is Constant Companion.
Yes po.
Third, she took over of all the application documents of Lucky South and Whirlwind.
Yes.
And if my memory serves me right, the fourth one that you said, he deals and meets
yes
with the people concerning Lucky South and Whirlwind. Do you confirm this?
Yes po.
Would you agree with me if I would say, malaki ang kinalaman ni Cassie Ong sa lahat ng activities ng mga companies na ito?
Yes, yes po.
You said yes.
Yes po. Siya po yung palagi kasama eh.
Thank you. Since Mr. De La Serna, kapag may titirang mga tao sa Lucky South, it is Cassie Ong who decides.
But in my case po, Your Honor, siya po yung kausap ko. Sa iba,
aside from you, may iba pa bang nakikitira dun sa Lucky South?
Hindi ko po alam, Your Honor.
Tumira ka doon is because Cassie Ong has the authority to decide for Lucky South. Hindi ka makakatira sa loob ng Lucky South.
Okay po, Your Honor.
You know Cassie Ong?
Yes, ma'am.
Why do you know her?
She went to our office po regarding Lucky South 99 po, regarding po the arrears that they have po in 2023.
And she was representing which company?
Lucky South 99.
And she was accompanied by?
Attorney Roque po.
I wish to address the question this time to Ms. Ong. Ms. Cassandra Ong, narinig mo ba ang testimonya nilang apat?
Yes po.
Kilala ka ni Baterna. Ikaw ang gumagamit ng cheque niya. And soon, we will be able to find out kung sinong binayaran mo using her checks. Kilala ka ni Ms. Mascareñas because you took a great part in the operation of Lucky South and Whirlwind. Are you listening, Ms. Cassandra Ong? Kilala ka rin ni Mr. De La Serna dahil ikaw ang nagpatira sa kanya. Kilala ka rin ng taga-PAGCOR dahil ikaw, kasama ni Attorney Harry Roque, ang naglalakad ng papeles ng Lucky South. You acknowledge that?
Mr., pwede po ako humingi ng 2 minutes to consult my lawyer.
2 minutes for what? Tinatanong ko lang kung naiintindihan mo. Nakilala ka nilang apat.
Yes po.
Of course. And are you aware of the case that have been filed, that has been filed already by PAOK with the Chinese national who were arrested within the premises of Lucky South? Alam mo ba kung anong kaso na ang isinampa?
Hindi po.
They were charged with qualified human trafficking. And by qualified human trafficking, Ms. Cassandra Ong, kagaya ng in-explain sa inyo ni Chairman Dan Fernandez, non-bailable offense yan. it is a capital offense. And with your direct participation in the operation of this Lucky South, there is a strong probability that you will be indicted as well for the crime of qualified human trafficking. Dahil sa testimonya nila at ng mga lulutang pangtestigo, maaring ikaw ay masampahan din ng qualified human trafficking, walang piyensa, capital offense. Nakahanda ka ba dito, Ms. Ong? Please answer the question, Ms. Ong.
You want 2 minutes for...
To talk to my lawyer po against my right.
You want to talk to your lawyer? I thought you're asking for the executive session. No? Not yet? Not yet?
Yes po.
Pare, will you allow it, Chairman?
Can I finish first, Mr. Chair, before
okay, please
she confers
proceed.
With
pagkatapos ng her lawyer. Tanong ni Congresswoman Luistro, we will give you 2 minutes.
Ms. Cassie Ong, look at me. I want you to understand, ikaw ang tinuturo ng maraming resource speakers na nakakaalam ng operasyon ng Lucky South. Kung saan nakita ang mga torture victims, ang mga murder victims, ang mga human trafficking victims. The pictures that were shown by Chairman Dan Fernandez. Sa katunayan, may mga Chinese nationals na nasampahan ng qualified human trafficking. And chances are, Ms. Ong, posible na ikaw ay mapasama sa kasong ito. Ang tanong, nauunawaan mo ba itong posibilidad na ito? Nauunawaan mo ba, Ms. Ong?
Yes po.
At kung nauunawaan mo, naiintindihan mo din ang posibilidad na ikimakulong, walang labasan, walang piyensa. Nauunawaan mo yun?
Pwede ko itanong sa lawyer ko about that.
Kasi Ong, now you are being offered an executive session. Because ako, I honestly believe you are just a tip of the berg. Would you like to avail of this executive session?
Pag-isipan ko po muna.